Although the Clone Wars were over, some people never seemed to get the message. The worst case of denial was Gizor Delso, a Geonosian separatist who'd somehow escaped Lord Vader's efforts to wipe out the remnants of the CIS. Lord Vader tracked him to Mustafar and brought us in to finish the job. It seemed like a simple enough mission. But when we saw the fleet of droid ships hovering over the planet, we suddenly realized that Delso's denial mechanisms were a little more dangerous than we'd imagined.
Mm-hmm. Alrighty, welcome back everyone. Let's get right into it.
Sir, the droids have landed on our ship. We can't launch our fighter.
Calm down, pilot. Get out there and destroy that droid. Anything necessary to clear the
being cheeky. Maybe. Shit. One more hit should do it. Or two more hits should do it.
Thank you.
Let's grab the bomber. Whatever it spawns back in. There we go.
Target that bomber and take him down. Take down that fighter.
But okay.
All engineers, report to the hangar area.
Let's go.
Excellent job, pilots. Lord Vader will be most pleased.
Beginning my attack run.
That. I love that. Flying around the TIE Interceptor. Oh my god. Oh, made me so happy.
The slight whiff of nostalgia the 501st had enjoyed fighting the droid fleet over Mustafar had already grown sour by the time we'd established orbital positions. Now it was time to find out what this was all about.
You're good of you. I never understood why they needed the strike bomber. It doesn't matter, let's get on to the next mission. See you in 3 seconds.
By the time we'd made our way to the molten surface of Mustafar, it was apparent that Delso had been a busy little bug. All by his lonesome, he'd found a previously hidden droid factory, fired it up and cranked out his own private army of battle droids. Needless to say, this got the men of the 501st a little hot under the helmet, and not just because of all that lava. Truth be told, we'd all had our fill of those gearheads during the war, and we couldn't stomach the thought of going through another one. So we blew them up. Blew up the droids, blew up the factory. Damn near blew up the planet.
As you should. Let's get into it. Freaking spawn thing.
Alright, troops. Today we stamp out final remnants of the CIA. Eventually we'll be blowing up a hidden droid factory. But for now, we need to infiltrate and secure that nearby mining system.
Oh, let's go.
Take control of the lava observation.
Open up, open up, open up. Alright, moving forward. Son of a bitch. Alright, good. We at least took that area. And we don't get it yet. Get on the exhaust fan. Got it.
Oh. the walkway.
Watch out for snipers.
Keep moving.
Sniper spotted at 2 o'clock.
Yeah, bad.
Base looks like a good place to make a stand. Capture it.
On a new Confederate infantry prototype. Destroy the schematics before they can move to build a destroyed army.
3-2.
Bringing the other beacon. Go out and retrieve it.
I'm gonna go over here now. move forward, guys. Move forward, move forward.
Fall back to the collection base and watch the fireworks.
Oh my god, I don't know if y'all heard that. That did not feel good.
Raining bugs!
Kill them all!
Shit. God, that was so intense. Oh my god, that was so freaking intense. I've never had a fight with that bug. That was that freaking back and forth.
The destruction of the mining facility put an end to any thoughts of a second droid rebellion. For the first time in years, the men of the 501st could relax and get about the business of maintaining an empire rather than building one.
God. Well, thank you all for watching. My name's Admiral Daly, and I'll catch y'all in the next episode.